everyone. My name is Emily, and this is another Artful review. Today, we will be looking at Chalkola Premium Chalk Markers. These markers are intended for use on things like car windows, glass, and whiteboards. Basically, any non-porous surface will work. Though you can use these markers on things like paper or canvas, they will lose their ability to be erased and may spread or bleed a little bit. Oh yeah, you heard me right. You can erase these guys. Unlike the similar Sharpie paint pen, you can remove the ink from any of the recommended surface with a wet cloth or a spritz of a water bottle. If you want your masterpiece to be permanent, you may use spray fixative in light layers to seal the ink. Be careful with this option though, because if you're spraying too much of the fixative on to the surface, it's going to smear the ink instead of seal it. To activate your pens, you need to press down on the spring-loaded nib. I found that long, slow presses help the ink to come out a bit faster. If the pens have been sitting for a while, I recommend repressing the nibs as well as shaking the entire pen to make sure the ink can be reincorporated. If you don't do this, your ink will come out watery and kind of separated. I found that every color was incredibly vibrant and very true to what was represented on the cap. I swatched all the colors on a white plastic lid, which was a bit more slippery than your average whiteboard. Even so, the majority of the colors stuck to the surface, with the exception of maybe one or two, and that was only because I hadn't shaken them enough. After letting the colors dry for a week, I was still able to remove almost every color without issue. Black, which is not pictured here but you'll see a little later, did stain very slightly upon erasing the first swatch. I went on doodling and erasing random pictures on this lid, switching colors as I went. Even after much abuse, there was still a little staining. If you are looking for something that will erase with absolutely zero stains, leaving your surface pristine as the driven snow, these markers aren't for you. However, what you may gain in erasing power in other brands, you will lose in vibrancy and opacity. They would be perfect for use on a chalkboard outside a cafe or asking someone to prom via car window message. I chose to use them on a mirror to make a cute piece of decor for my son's nursery. They were perfect for use on the surface, showing up incredibly opaque. Once the ink is dry, if you need to make your lines a little thicker, draw adjacent to your first line opposed to drawing over it. I find one swipe is more than enough to make the color perfectly opaque, and if you draw atop your first layer, it will just remove that layer from your surface. I found that with a fingernail or a credit card, you can chip away the ink with relative ease, which I actually find to be a huge pro. You can make your own scratch boards with these markers, opening a whole new dimension of artistic possibility. I had a lot of fun experimenting with the Chalkola markers, and I'll be using them to make fun decoration pieces for my upcoming baby shower. I really believe anyone from crafters to professional artists can find a use for these markers. If you're a holiday junkie like me, they'll be great for creating works of art all throughout the seasons to put on display for your family to enjoy. I'll make sure to include a coupon code linked down below for you guys to get 15% off your purchase of these bad boys. I also want to thank the Chalkola company for sending me these markers to try out. I was kind of surprised because, you know, they're just chalk markers, but they were really vibrant and I ended up messing with them for hours at a time. There have been multiple times in the past where I've used similar products on my car or on a chalkboard or something like that, and none of them were quite as satisfactory to use as these guys. I also want to remind y'all that I'm not going to be doing reviews on anything unless I absolutely love it or, on the flip side, absolutely hate it. I know review videos isn't something you guys have been totally craving from me lately, but keep in mind that I am a busy little beaver right now, making a baby in my tummy and taking care of my family and trying to get all my stuff together before the baby gets here, but I'm definitely trying to make more time to make videos, and that is why I'm gonna give you guys a little heads up that there will be a sketchbook story time next week. I am very excited to release it. I still have not recorded the artwork for it because I want the artwork to be kind of meaningful, so I'm kind of brainstorming right now. What's really kind of convenient and nice about PR videos and review videos is that I can kind of shut off the creative side of my brain. Because the process for review videos is a lot different than the process for the other videos that I do. It's a lot more technical and straightforward. I run a lot of tests on these products. The sketches are a bit more simple so that I can test these products to the best of my ability. And I write a script, so I can almost let my creative side rest to regenerate for more contemplative videos or creative videos or I haven't done any spiritual videos, but you know, videos that take more emotional thought opposed to technical thought. I would really like my channel to be a mix of both. I'm not doing any announcements in this video because there will be more announcements in my sketchbook storytime video. I just wanted to run through a couple things really quickly. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and don't forget to stay out of trouble. See you guys later.